Hey friends, Azure Cosmos DB keeps getting better with a preview of notebook support. We've got Apache Spark in Cosmos, great new optimizations and queries. Idiomatic SDK is now on version 3. I'm here with Kirill. We're going to learn all about it on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Kirill Gavrylyuk, who is fast becoming my favorite person because you keep bringing me amazing updates to Cosmos DB.
Thank you, Scott. It's such an honor to be here, and thank you for tolerating me for so many times. Today, we really have good news. We released a number of updates over the past couple months. We call them summer updates for Cosmos DB, starting with built-in support for notebooks, Jupyter notebooks, and Spark.
Wow.
So now you can go and create a Cosmos DB account, and you can enable Spark. Notebooks you can enable come with Spark, or you can enable them later. And you can use it with any of the APIs. And it really brings, makes your queries, you work with Cosmos DB personal, right? So here's kind of just a quick preview, and we have another episode on this. Cosmos DB comes with Data Explorer, and now in Data Explorer, you have integrated support for Jupyter Notebooks. What does it mean? It doesn't mean not only you can do queries like you did before, but now you can create notebooks, and notebooks bring you, you can select a kernel, let's say Python, and now you can type your queries, add graphs, add charts, create live reports.
Wow.
For your standing, for example, here's, I have one of the containers has data about earthquakes. And I can run through it quickly. And here I'm getting all the earthquakes within 30,000 miles around 30 miles around Seattle. And this is thanks to the geospatial queries that Cosmos DB gives you, right? This is just T-SQL. And now I can not only get this data, but I can also visualize it using one of the popular Jupyter extensions. Right, wow. And now we have this results on a map.
This is such a natural thing. Why didn't you do this first? It's such an obvious natural thing.
I think we had some groundwork to be done to run all these, because this is all running code containers next to the data. But now that we have that groundwork, we can do a lot of things. We can do Jupyters, and as examples, we can now kind of run Spark next to the data. You can do, and it's your Spark, so you can select your, what size of the worker, what size of the driver. You can get operational insights into how your workers are doing. But it comes with notebooks, and it runs directly to the data, so you can avoid data movement.
Not making copies, no silos.
Yes, and you can, and not only that, you can also enable autoscale, for example, autoscale when idle, and save a lot of money, because Spark is aware of Cosmos DB. When Cosmos DB's throughput goes down, Spark can go idle, we can shrink. So we can save you a lot of money.
Wow.
By having this awareness.
What a great feature.
We love it. We have another episode on it. So we'll dive deep there.
All right.
The next one is, for a while, we had this Data Explorer capability inside Azure Portal, where you work with data with Cosmos DB. And it's good for writing a couple queries. But we also released a standalone version of it, full screen. And recently, and it's been out there for a while, but recently we added Active Directory login support in it. So now I can sign in with my Azure credentials and select my account right here, select my subscription, select my account, and start working with it. No more dealing with connection strings. So now it becomes a very aligned with Azure Portal, kind of just extension to Azure Portal that gives you full screen space for your queries.
Very natural, and you've got a great cosmos.azure.com URL. And for people who live in Cosmos, who felt like they've been seeing this much of the data, now they can see this much of the data.
Exactly.
Very nice.
Now, that's a good segue. Let's use this tool to see some interesting improvements we did with queries. So Cosmos DB is a great operational database. But for a while, we had a weak spot where our aggregate queries tend to be expensive and slower, because all the optimization is about ingesting data very fast, doing point operations very fast in real time, less than 10 millisecond latencies. We've paid less attention to aggregates, right, and analytical queries. Now we pay a lot more attention to that. And with that, we were adding improvements that gave us up to 100x performance savings with aggregate queries.
Wow.
Let me show you. So here I have two collections. Okay. They are identical in terms of the data that they have.
All right.
This is the collection that runs using the old query engine.
All right.
Without improvements. And let's do a quick query. And we're going to do an aggregate query select count. And it takes some time to run. Maybe it'll take 20 seconds to run, right? Mm. It's not a huge collection. It's about 2 million documents. So eventually it'll come. It came down 2 million documents. But it took something, about 20 to 30 seconds. Now let's take this query and run on the new query engine that we have right here. Instantaneous.
You sure you're not cheating? Same data. You're not cheating?
Same two million
documents. That's not a cache, right?
It's not a cache. It's the internal details is that before we had to read all the documents, even for aggregates,
right.
Even to count them.
Right.
We loaded them for
table disk. Scan, effectively.
Yes. I mean, not it's still utilized the index, but we loaded the data.
Right, indeed.
Now we don't need to. So now we don't load, our indexes got much better. We don't have to load the, just to do aggregates, we don't have to load the
full
document.
So fundamental engine improvements and everybody wins.
And it's less cost, which is important. Aggregate queries
tend to
be very expensive.
Because less
compute. Disk IO.
Yes. Oh, less disk IO.
Less cost and much faster.
So is this something that I'm going to get for free? Did someone wake up on Wednesday and then they said, oh, it's Azure Friday. Everything got faster. What happened? How did this get faster?
We are rolling it out. So at the beginning, you have to ask to onboard your account.
Okay.
And we just need to turn on a switch
That's
behind
awesome.
The scenes. And once we feel confident that it works, no edge cases,
right.
It works, we'll roll it out for everyone.
Everything gets faster and cheaper, and it just happens.
That's what we strive for.
Woo! That's good stuff, sir.
Thank you. We are really excited about this. This kind of finishes the arc of the query. And then to last but not least, we're announcing a few updates around our developer story. We talked about new SDKs that we've released, which are a lot more idiomatic, modern, better programming model, more intuitive, shorter, mm-hmm. less third, as we call it. And we've done this work for .NET, Java, and JavaScript.
Okay.
Now today we're announcing general availability of it.
So this is idiomatic, meaning it feels natural.
To the language.
To the language.
.NET SDK does not feel like C++ anymore. Java SDK does not feel like .NET anymore. JavaScript SDK, it's just good.
Yeah, it's just good. So it speaks the language that you speak. It's going to feel very natural. So if you're a JavaScript programmer and you like working with JavaScript, you're going to love working with JavaScript on Cosmos. It just feels natural.
And you'll be more productive, a lot less code to write.
So that's generally available. People can go and get those SDKs right now.
Yep, that's right.
That's a huge summer update.
So Jupyter Notebooks, CosmosAzure.com with AAD, up 100x performance improvements, and GA of SDKs.
100x, two orders of magnitude.
You're doing some
amazing stuff over there. I continue to appreciate Cosmos DB and everything that you all do. Fantastic. I am learning all about the great summer update to Azure Cosmos DB today on Azure Friday.